Welcome back. This is Aichon.
And Smappy.
And Smappy is back.
Smappy!
Smappy. Anyway, we are back now with Full Throttle, and we're in the town of Melonweed. Smappy, bring us up to speed.
For some reason, you know, all of a sudden I thought the main character's name was Jim Raynor. But that's not what we're playing. Anyways, no, wrecked our bike, and we're supposed to get, what, three things? The welding torch, the forks, and the gasoline, and we already have the welding torch.
Which came from here.
Yeah, and I'm guessing that the forks comes from the building up ahead.
And what sort of forks are these, like spoon and forks?
I don't know, I guess some kind of motorcycle part named fork.
Yeah, so it's the part that like connects to the tire on the front.
Oh! Okay.
Yeah, exactly. And the whole reason why we need these is because we wrecked our bike and because we need to get up to stop an ambush of our gang, so...
Yeah, we don't want the gang ambushed. We're not having the gang ambush people.
Exactly. Something like that.
I like how there's only an entrance, but no exit. You can go in, but not out.
It's probably labeled exit on the inside.
We'll have to figure that out.
Heavy looking.
Let's punch it.
Open up, Todd.
Yeah, that's not going to work because if you remember the last video, Todd was the guy we knocked out in the trailer.
Yeah, I don't think he's... Why didn't we just take his keys?
He doesn't have keys.
How does he get in?
Probably just lifts the door up.
Well, oh, I guess...
He's a strong
Open
sort
up,
of...
Todd.
No. Wait, what's this thing down here? Can we examine it?
No luck. This should be easy.
Oh, so yeah, we just... No, wait, I can't...
Open up, Todd.
No okay. Lock?
No lock, so...
Just open it.
It comes out a hole in the bottom and goes over that pulley to the other side of the wall.
Well, let's see what happens if we pull it. Punch. There we go. Let's go in.
So you need to somehow, I'm sure, weigh it down so it doesn't close.
What, do you mean the pulley?
Yeah, because if you let go, isn't it going to drop?
Well, you're just thinking ahead. Okay,
I think you should weigh it down with the meat!
The meat. Let's try the meat. Oh, and still, I can't remember, did we show this in the last video, but if you have more inventory items that could fit in the skull, you get a little arrow up in the eyeball.
Okay.
So, yeah. Let's try the meat.
That's not one of meat's many uses.
Aww.
He's not going to tell us what meat's many uses are, is he?
Not right now. Okay, so what we need to do here, take the lock that we got off the electric fence from the gas place. And now it is locked.
Oh, I see what you're going to do.
That should hold it.
Exactly. So now it's going to hold it, and now we punch the pulley thing.
Ah, junk.
Now, I don't know if you could see it, but there was something run around over there. And if you remember from the trailer, we knew that Todd had a rather large dog, so...
It must be a cat!
Exactly. Barracuda cat.
One of those rogue barracudas from Operation Neptune.
Let's examine this pile.
Just the kind of forks I need, right on top.
There we go. Let's grab one.
Down. That's one ill-tempered mongrel.
Okay, so the deal is, as we walk around this place, if we ever try to interact with that pile again, like to grab anything, the dog will come and chase us back up here.
That's
the only pile of forks in the place. So there are some other things around here, though, but they're just cars. So like if we go over here, these all are cars.
Cars? No, thank you.
And this one.
Ooh, fire damage. Forget about it.
Yeah.
The car next to it on the right looks like it has wheels.
This one?
Yeah. I thought all the cars in this game were hover cars.
Well, this is the junkyard, so... They could be old cars.
True.
So that's kind of tricky right there. It actually does scroll over if you move over to the side of the screen.
And then we can go in.
Yeah, then we can go into the next screen. And if we stay here too long. Yeah, it's a bit of a puzzle. If we stay here too long, the dog comes after us. So clearly we need to do something. Now we have this this meat here. Oops, I stayed too long. I'll just hit escape.
Yeah, you can skip cinematics by hitting escape.
Yeah. Like that.
For those who are lazy.
Well, when you get like this sort of thing where you just have to keep doing it over and over until you get it right, it saves a lot of time.
Well, if you do that in real life, like, I don't want to go to the dentist, escape, and suddenly you're home again. You're like, yay!
Anyway, oops.
Sorry.
I have to go to the dentist next week. But, anyway, as far as how to solve this, we can use the meat. And we want to get the dog into one of these cars, so let's just pick this one.
Here, Poochie Pooch. Pooch.
Apparently, this is one of meat's many uses.
Bon appetit, mud.
So if we examine... Yeah, we don't want to go in there. But the dog is still back there in that car. Now, you probably saw the crane. Oh, was that?
Sorry.
You probably saw the crane. That's more of this... Oops, no, don't go... No. Get back up here. Okay, let's see if I can get the clicking right on this. No, not there. It's over here somewhere. Well, there it is.
Oh my gosh, are you serious?
Yeah, it's kind of ridiculous, so...
That's not really fair.
No, it's not. That one I always thought was kind of stupid. You actually can do it, I think. Like, if you're down there, I think you can, like, click up here, and it'll, like, walk you all this around. But as far as getting it from up here... Yeah.
So what are you gonna do, pick up the dog?
Basically so, yeah. So the three controls here, this button initiates the magnet. This one moves the thing around, kind of like a, you know, grapple arm. And then this one goes up and down. So we're already over the car we want to hit, so let's just go down. Okay, and then turn it on. And then up we go. Okay, and let's just leave him there. I was gonna say, a while ago when Smappy and I were practicing this at one point, I don't know if Smappy remembers this or not, but she was directing me where to put the car before we had put the meat in the car. So the dog was just out there, and she directed me where to put it, and we dropped the car on the dog.
By accident, I do not condone violence against dogs.
We dropped the car on the dog, and the dog kind of whimpered a few times, but then it, oops, I totally just cut off whatever he was going to say. Well, I think he was just going to say that it's safe now or something, so.
Yeah, the dog actually ran under the car as we were putting it down.
Yeah, he did. But dropped it on the dog, he whimpered, and but then he came out and chased us out after a little while ago, so he was fine.
Just the kind of forks I need.
Oh.
Nice forks. Where'd you find them?
Right next to the knives and spoons.
Just gotta gas her up and go.
Okay, so we just need to get the gas. Let's check the mailbox one more time.
I have this obsession with the mailbox.
I know it gets some mail in it at some point in this game. I just can't remember when.
It's That's empty.
Today is not my lucky day. Okay, so we have the gas can and the tube. We need to figure out how to get some gas into the gas can.
So obviously touching the tower is not going to work, and I'm pretty sure that licking the tower is not going to get anything, so...
Yeah, well,
I know
you actually...
people been commenting about my obsession about licking is just as bad as an obsession with the beds and Suikoden. I don't mean for it. I'm just curious to see what his responses are going to be.
So, you're actually pretty close. You said run away, but you didn't quite pick the right place to run to, so... Here's what the trick is. You come over to here, touch it, and then instead of running off screen, we run back here into the shadows. Somewhere back here. I think I maybe got it.
private property. Remain still, and we will not shoot you.
Guess I missed it.
I get the safe fire before you do that, Floyd.
Sorry, boss. Not exactly.
Let's try again.
Let's try again. I missed the spot. There's some spot back there in the shadows that you can go to. There we go. Behind the thing.
I don't know why that alarm.
Hey, where is he? I nailed him last time. But who set off the alarm, Floyd?
Maybe somebody's just fooling with us.
It's him. It's that guy you keep missing.
Well, if you can hold this thing still while I'm shooting,
I'm going down for a closer look.
I don't see nobody. He must have run away.
Yeah, we would have seen him running from the air. He must be hiding up in the tower.
We got him treed.
Let's go up and get him.
Let's steal their car. Let's steal the gas from their car.
Oh, you catch on way too fast.
Oh my gosh, is that really it?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Let's touch it.
Don't think so.
Yeah, that's what I thought. So if we come over here, examine?
I'd say that's where the gas goes.
If we examine the main thing.
I don't trust anything without wheels.
So, punch it. Okay, and then get our gas can out. And then get our tube out.
He's got a really big jacket.
Yeah, it's like a bag of holding. And then here's where your specialty comes in.
Oh my gosh, really? Are you gonna lick it?
Yes. So you have to prime it.
Who's that down there in the yard?
It's him. Get him.
Where?
Over there. Quick. You go around the other side and we'll have him cornered.
Where'd he go? Let's call it quits, huh, boss?
No. Let's call on reinforcements.
Did you just dump the gas everywhere?
Eh, we got plenty.
Oh, good. You get this from the gas tower?
Not exactly.
Well, that's it. Wait outside for a minute and I'll finish you up. I'm working on a surprise.
I hate surprises.
All right, here she comes. Am I cool or what?
You're amazing. I should crash that thing every day. So what's the surprise?
Oh, just your average everyday pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster.
You're serious?
Yes.
But only the vultures.
I have my connections. Now, are you going to try this thing out or not? Ooh-wee. Wish I had a camera.
I wish I had some way of paying you back.
Just beat it, will ya? You're scaring away my regular customers.
Bye, Mo.
Send me a postcard from the ambush.
Anyway, we probably need to cut off here, so we will pick it back up later. Bye, guys.
I feel like she's evil. She's Rip Burger's evil companion.